This is the Junghans Meister Chronoscope. This is the chronograph. Meister is the top end of the Junghans collection. Junghans are based in the Black Forest in Schramberg. This is a beauty. It has this sort of retro feel to the design. This bracelet also has a slightly retro feel to it. The watch has two chronograph counters. It's a tri-compact layer. You've basically got two registers, a 30-minute register and a 12-hour chronograph register. Small seconds display. And then on this side, we've got both a date and a day aperture. One of the things that's quite interesting is that basically Junghans are trying to create a balance of symmetry. And so if you actually look at the scale of the two chronograph registers, they're identical and they sit sort of above each other. Whereas if you actually look at the small seconds display, it's smaller in scale. And the counterbalance is provided really with the small seconds on one hand and the data which are on the other side. And it just creates this lovely equilibrium to the appearance of the watch. In terms of the display as well, you'll spot that it has a sapphire crystal, which is what we call box glass sapphire, so it actually domes slightly. And if you actually look at the actual dial surface, again it's cambered, it actually sort of slopes to the sides if you look at the watch. The other thing is that the bracelet, if you actually look at it, it's what's called a seven rose bracelet. It has seven rows on it. And if you actually look at the push pieces, they're actually slightly discreet in profile. They're actually not quite oval, but they're pretty well near as damn it. And the crown itself is very neat. It's got a very neat knurling pattern. And neatness and again, sort of this sort of understatement is one of the characteristics of Junghans. Just have a slight Bauhaus feeling, perhaps not quite as much as the Max build, but again, it just has this sort of Bauhaus sort of character to it. Also, if you look at the back of the watch, it has an exhibition case back. And again, if you look at the rotor, it's adorned with a Côte de Genève, and also the bridge work underneath is adorned with the Côte de Genève, and there's also thermal blue screws in evidence. It's a very, very appealing proposition. For me, I think one of the things that I like about it is that it's refined, it's understated, it doesn't crave attention. And I keep going back to this. Quite often we see now watches which are very blingy, conspicuous, they basically crave attention. That might appeal to some people. Personally, I quite like it when people are not quite sure what I've got on the wrist. Why do I really want to sort of brandish my watch in front of people? I want it to be sort of quiet, understated and refined. I want to know that it's high quality, high precision, and that it's been executed to a very high standard. And that's what Junghans provides.